So how are bass managed in the state of Washington? Well, that depends on location, available habitat, and native species conservation efforts. Now, most of our lakes fall under the statewide general rule, which for largemouth, that's a 5-fish limit, but all largemouth between 12 and 17 inches must be released. You can also only keep one over 17 inches. Now, for smallmouth bass, those populations are a little bit larger, so we have a 10-fish limit, but all smallmouth over 14 inches must be released. Exceptions to this rule occur in lakes and reservoirs connected to rivers with ocean-going salmon, including the Columbia River downstream of Chief Joseph Dam and its tributaries. Here, there are no protections for largemouth, smallmouth, and walleye. There are also a number of lakes and reservoirs in western Washington in particular where the limits were recently increased, but we still have protections in place for quality largemouth and smallmouth. In a nutshell, these regulations reflect a spectrum of fish management priorities, from favoring warm water fish in many lakes to native species protection in our rivers and streams. Now, the federal government and our interstate neighbors, Idaho and Oregon, recognize that there are many sources of predation on salmon at all stages of their life cycle, from their natal streams where the fish spawn and the eggs hatch, to streams and side channels where the fish rear, to large rivers where the smolts outmigrate and the adults return. And managers are working very hard to limit predation and improve the survival of salmon. Now, to that end, there's been unprecedented changes to the Marine Mammal Protection Act, as well as shorebird protections, that have increased the amount of birds and also pinnipeds like seals and sea lions that can be lethally removed from the Columbia River system. In the face of these unprecedented changes, and also recognizing that the state operates a bounty program on northern pike minnow, a native species and another predator to salmon, it's very difficult for the state to justify having protections for non-native game fish that we know, at least in some part, contribute to this portion of overall salmon, overall predation on salmon. Now, we recognize, and the Fish and Wildlife Commission also recognizes, that warm water angling contributes a tremendous amount to the economy, second only to trout fishing. Now, this, balanced with our conservation mandate and native species protections, the Fish and Wildlife Commission recently adopted a new policy called the Non-Native Game Fish Policy, and this is going to direct the agency on where and how it's appropriate to manage warm water game fish in Washington. If you'd like more information on this policy, you can go to our website, click on About WDFW, click on Fish and Wildlife Commission, and then click on Non-Native Game Fish Policy Development. I hope this brief overview gives you a better idea of our regulations as well as the policies that are driving management. Thanks so much for watching, and thank you for your continued support.